These were the last three words that he uttered. But the Bible records, Brother Deacon, that after he said it, the old folks said he dropped his head in the locks of his shoulder and died. Those were the last words that came out of his mouth. Three words similar to "I love you." Amen. And I can see that because he was committing an act of love. But y'all gonna hear me preach? By dying on the cross. He said, "It is finished." And listen, that was final. That was once and for all. Within these three words are the conclusion of Jesus' purpose to come into the world. He completed his job and his calling. All the sin that was brought into the Garden of Eden by Satan was made forgiven by these three words. Are y'all going to pray with me?
Amen.
It is finished. And my brothers and sisters, after these three words, there was nothing else to be said. Mm-hmm. All that Jesus said and did are summed up in these three words.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And when we contemplate the death of Jesus, we must consider the price that he paid.
Amen.
I don't think we really understand to the extent of fullness of the price that Jesus paid, not for himself, but for us. Rockefeller, Henry Ford, Vanderbilt, Bill Gates, Oprah Winfrey, all the money them people got cannot compete nor compare to the price that Jesus paid.
Amen.
For you to be sitting where you're sitting right now.
Amen.
Not so much as sitting in this building, but the Bible says we are seated in heavenly places with him. And because he died and paid the price, you have a right to the tree of life.
Yes, sir.
And I don't think that really has sunk into a lot of people's mind to really grasp the real understanding of that. That was something that was done that you could have never done for yourself.
Amen.
Man can come to outer space, but he can't come to inner space. He can go to the moon, he can go to Mars, but he can't do nothing with himself.
Amen.
Jesus is the only one.
Well,
come on, say amen, y'all.
Amen.
I remember years ago when I first started pastoring here, and I would get mad because people weren't coming to church and folk weren't coming to Bible study. And I'd go home and cry, I mean literally, and get headaches and whatnot. And I said, why won't they do right? Why won't the people come to church? Why won't they come to Bible study? Until the Lord sat me down one day and told me like a natural man, he said, I'm the only one that can control people. Hallelujah. He said, you can get up in bed till you're blue in the face, but I'm the only one that can make folk do. And when the Lord said that to me, a weight lifted off of me, and I never begged him no more. Hallelujah. I was missing my blessing, trying to get them to do what only God could get them to do. But brothers and sisters, we must consider the great price that was paid over 2,000 years ago for us to be saved today. And enough money in Fort Knox ain't enough gold in the reserve to pay for your salvation. We must consider the price that was paid. Can I get a witness in here?
Amen.
Come on and say thank God.
Thank God.
The price paid by Christ is captured in his dying declaration when he said it is finished. It shows the magnitude of the price that was paid. Come on and say amen. When he uttered those words, it showed how much he loved us. When he uttered those words, it showed how much he cared. When he uttered those words, it showed how far he was willing to go. When he uttered those words, it showed how much agony. Come on, somebody. How much agony. Talk to me. How much pain he would go through in order for you to enjoy salvation. I'm glad about that. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
When was the last time you got happy because you were saved? When was the last time you got happy because you looked and saw what Jesus did for you? When's the last time you got happy that you ain't going to hell? When's the last time you got happy that your name is written in the book of life? When was the last time you got happy that you know one day you're going where the wicked will cease from traveling and the weary will be at rest? Somebody ought to clap your hands over your mouth and say something. Tell somebody, it is finished. Say, it is finished. It is finished. Turn, it is finished is summed up in a Hebrew word. Those of you that came in this morning, if you looked at the marquee on the outside, you saw the title of my sermon, It Is Finished. But under that, you saw a word. And then when I was putting it up yesterday, and Evangelist Johnson and her daughter was coming by, and they saw me, and they started laughing. I said, what y'all laughing at? They thought I had lost my mind because they didn't know what that word was I was putting up there. I had to let them know that that was a Hebrew word. Come on, say amen, y'all. Tetalicia simply means in the Hebrew, it is finished. Come on, say amen. And that word has three meanings to it. Not only it is finished, but it means to show a bill paid in full. Oh, come on and say amen. How do we know it's a good thing? It's a wonderful feeling, Daisy, when you can go and buy good clothes and shoes and stuff, and you get ready to pay for it, and somebody behind you say, I got it. Somebody behind you say, I'm going to pay for that. How do we know that's what Jesus did when he said it is finished? He said, give me the bill. Lord have mercy. Not only did he pay for the bill, but he laid the tip on top of that. Ain't nothing like going to a restaurant, getting ready to pay your bill, and the maid way to tell you it's already been paid. I don't know why, but that food would taste a little bit better knowing that somebody else paid for it. Come on, say amen. So that word means to show a bill has been paid in full. Look at what I said, paid in full. I'm glad he didn't pay half of it. I'm glad he didn't pay two-thirds of it. My God, but he paid all of it. And I'm glad about it because he paid it for one time. It ain't never got to be paid no more. Come on and say hallelujah. He put it there for one time. I'm so glad he ain't got to go back to the cross. He ain't got to come here and suffer and die no more. He said, I'm going to do it one time. How do we know sometimes one time covers it all? Come on and say thank God. So it means to show a bill paid in full. That word means a task finished. How many know Jesus didn't leave a task undone? He finished the task. Come on and say thank God. That's what he was trying to say in that second text of John 4:34. He said, my meat is not of this world. My meat is to do the will of the Father and to finish what he sent me to do. Come on and say thank God. Aren't you glad that 2,000 years ago on a hill called Calvary, Jesus finished? Come on and say thank God. He didn't leave no stone unturned. He didn't leave no task undone. He did everything he was supposed to do. He healed the sick. He raised the dead. He walked on the water. He turned the water to wine. He, come on, somebody. He preached the gospel. He went around doing good. He healed the sick. He cast out devils. He laid hands on the sick. He said, Father, everything that you sent me to do, I finished the task. Come on, that word means a task finished. Then that word means a sacrifice offered. Having no Jesus offered himself. He offered himself. Say thank God. Didn't nobody tell Jesus to do it. God didn't tell him to do it. Jesus said, I'll do it. Can I fathom in my mind, y'all? Let me fathom in my mind. I'm up in heaven. Before Jesus was born, I see him sitting at the table. I see God. I see Jesus. And I see the Holy Ghost. And God is sitting there with tears in his eyes. And Jesus says to God, why are you crying? God said, I'm crying because the man I made turned out to be messed up. He said, I'm crying because my masterpiece turned out to be messed up. I'm crying because Satan has taken over my creation. And Jesus looks at his Father and said, well, Father, isn't there somebody that can redeem man back? And the Father said, no, because when Adam sinned, all became sinners. Jesus said, Daddy, I tell you what you do. Just prepare me a body, and I'll go down there, and I'll redeem man back to you. About that time, the Holy Ghost said, wait a minute, Jesus. If you go down there and save him, I'll go down there and sanctify him, and I'll fill him with the Holy Ghost. Aren't you glad about that? Aren't you glad? Jesus, my God, was the perfect sacrifice. Didn't he do it, y'all? Somebody say, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. And here in the text of St. John 19:25 and through verse number 30, here in the text, brother deacons, Jesus is in his final moments on the cross. He gives his mother to John as her son because Jesus knew that he was finna to die, and he didn't want his mother to be childless. So what Jesus said, John, behold your new mother. And he said, mother, behold your new son, because I'm getting ready to leave here. Let me hear you say hallelujah. Come on and say thank God. Say it again, thank God. The Bible said after he gave Mary to John and John to Mary, he utters the words of our text. It is finished. My suffering, the purchase of man's redemption. When he said it is finished, it may have ruptured some vessels in his heart. But no sooner had he uttered it than he bowed his head upon his breast and yielded up his life and died and became a ransom for many. When Jesus said, Brother Wayne, that it is finished, a blood vessel in his heart burst. Come on, killing him instantly. But then he dropped his head in the locks of his shoulder. But can I reverse y'all? Can I rewind? Let me go back. Let me go back the night before. How they whipped him all night long. The Bible said they were at the cross and they were gambling, my God, for the robe of Jesus. Somebody want to know what was so special about the robe of Jesus? He had a seamless garment. It had no beginning and it had no end. For he declared, I'm Alpha and I am Omega. I am the beginning and I am the end. When they took the robe off him, they threw a purple robe on him. So you, if you're a king, you gotta look like one. And they went to the thorn bush and got 72 thorns, which represent 3 days, and wrapped it up in a crown and put it on his head. Come on, somebody. And then they took him down Golgotha's hill, which is known as the hill of skull, which is known as Calvary. Calvary was a dump site. Calvary was a garbage place. Come on, somebody. And before they got him there, they took him to the carpenter shop and made him pick out his own cross. Come on, somebody. And they put that cross on his back. And I see Jesus. I preach, if y'all help me. I said, I see Jesus. Somebody said, Jesus. I see Jesus climbing up that hill called Calvary. The pressure had got to him. There were crowds on both sides. The weight of the cross knocked him to his knees. There was a soldier there. He looked at a black man by the name of Simon and said, pick up his cross and carry it for him. What a joy it must have been to carry the cross of Jesus. I heard the songwriter say, must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free. Bear the cross for everyone and bear the cross for me. Shall I preach? Should I preach? Somebody point and say, preach, preach. And they gave the cross back to Jesus. And while he was stumbling up there, the women began to weep and the women began to mourn. Jesus stopped in his tracks and looked at the women and said, weep not for me, but weep for your babies that have been sucked in that day. He said, oh, weep for me, weep for Jerusalem. Come on, somebody. When he got there to Calvary, I said, when he got to Calvary, they laid him down. They laid the cross down. Come on, somebody. The old preacher said, Jesus said, if you think I'll run, nail my feet. If you think I'll fight you, nail my hand. Am I right about it? They were doing real good. Brother Butch, they were doing good. As long as Jesus was on the cross and the cross was on the ground. But they made a fatal mistake. They lifted him up. But he said, if I be lifted up, I draw men unto me. Did he do it, y'all? I said, did he do it? Say yes. Say, yeah. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. Oh, yes, he did. They whipped him. They beat him. While he was on that cross, he uttered them words. They stuck him in the side. Now, the surgeon said, the doctor said, that when they stuck him in the side, it went through the abdomen and pierced the heart. And out came blood for your redemption. Out came water for your baptism. Didn't he do it, y'all? I said, did he do it? He was about to die, but the thief on the right, he said, Jesus, remember me when you're coming to your kingdom. Come on, say it. Jesus stopped dying. He told death to hold up. He told rigor mortis to wait a minute. I got to open the door of the church. He said, this day, you're going to be with me in paradise. Then Jesus said, come on, death, where is your sting? Come on, grave, where is your victory? And then the Bible said, he said, it's finished. Dropped his head in the locks of his shoulder. They took Jesus, your Lord and my God, put him in a borrowed tomb. Somebody said it was borrowed because he wouldn't need it for 3 days. Talk to me, y'all. I see Jesus in that tomb. I see Jesus at three places at one time. What do you mean, Pastor? His body was in the tomb. His spirit was with God. But his soul had a job to do. And I saw the soul of Jesus get out the body. Went down to the down escalator. Went down to hell. Oh, yes, he did. Knocked on the door and said, lift up your hands, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting door. The devil jumped up and put his ear to the door and said, who is the King of Glory? Jesus said, I am mighty in battle. Kicked open the door. Can I get over in here? But Sunday morning, he got it with some power, black power, Georgia power, political power, all power. Lift your hand and say, oh! Somebody clap your hands. Somebody clap your hands. Say, all power. Not some power, but all power. I'm glad. I said, I'm glad it is finished. Tell somebody it's finished. Tell somebody it's over. Tell somebody it's a done deal. Tell somebody it's a wrap. He finished it when he dropped his head in the locks on the shoulder. Somebody said that when he died, I said, when he died, the sun refused to shine. I can understand that. Because two suns can't shine at once. So the S-U-N stepped back. And the S-O-N stepped up. Somebody said, when he died, the sun refused to shine. Because the, hallelujah, the light of the universe went out. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because Jesus said, I am the light of the world. But when he died, the world blew a fuse. Lord have mercy. Darkness covered the world because a just man had been killed, because an innocent man had been died. But I'm so glad. I preach if y'all help me here. I'm so glad. He loved everybody. He died for everybody. He died for the white man, the black man, the yellow man, the blue man, the woman, the boy and girl, whoever you are. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Even if you don't want Jesus, even if you don't accept Jesus, he still died for you. Can I get a witness? Even if you don't believe in him, he still died for you. He died for everybody. It's a historical fact. It's a prophetic fact. It's a biblical fact. It is factual. He died. But he got up. Come on, say amen. You go to the grave sites of all the presidents of America that died.
Yes, sir.
Roosevelt, Lincoln, Ford, on, talk to me. Yes. Taft. Yes. Come on, say McKinley. Yes. Abraham Lincoln.
Yes.
Monroe Jackson. All of them that died.
Yes.
You go over to the grave site.
Yes.
And dig them up.
Yes.
And what's left of them is still there.
Yes.
Y'all don't like me.
Yes.
Come on and say thank God.
Yes.
You go to the graveyard of Alexander the Great. And see what you see. Alexander the Great is still there.
Go to
Italy. Go to Italy to the grave of my God, Bonaparte.
Yes, sir.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
And see, won't he still there? Can I get a witness?
Yes.
Come on and say, thank God.
Yes.
But follow me over to Jerusalem.
Yes.
And let's go to the grave of where they put him.
Yes,
and the empty tomb yet speaks.
Yes, sir.
He is not here.
The
devil tried to lie and said somebody stole him away. The devil tried to lie and said Jesus didn't die. He went into a coma. Y'all ain't talking to me. Some people try to say he just swooned. Word swooned, he fainted. Swooned or not, he ain't there. Where is he? He on the right hand of God. Making intercession for you and I. Somebody say the love of God. Say it louder. The love of God. God love everybody.
Amen.
Ain't no man got no monopoly on God.
Amen.
You can't buy God.
Amen.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Amen.
I found out in my 54 years of living, you can't buy love.
Amen.
You can't buy love, honey. I want somebody to love me in spite of and not because of.
Amen.
Don't love me because of what I can give you.
Amen.
Love me if I ain't got nothing. I don't care if I'm shaped fine when I marry you and get bigger than 2 liters 10 years later.
Yes, sir.
Two of them, 250 pounds, you got to love every 250 pounder.
Yes,
come on, say amen, y'all.
Amen.
Folks will use you and throw you away.
Yes,
but they can't get nothing else out of you. That ain't love.
Yeah.
And God didn't do that. Jesus didn't do that. We were reading in Sunday school. We're going to let's go. We're reading in Sunday school where it said, please God to bruise him.
Yeah.
And I explained to them, Brother Chairman, that didn't mean that the Lord God was in heaven rejoicing over his son being crucified. When it said, please God to bruise him, God was pleased that Jesus allowed them to do him like that.
Amen.
God was pleased that Jesus showed love.
Because
yes, the Bible said he never said a he didn't even open his mouth. He was dumb like a lamb before shearer or a lamb before slaughter. When you killing a lamb ain't fighting.
No, sir.
He'll lay right there and let you cut the wool off him and then kill it.
Yes, sir.
But if you mess around and get one of them goats, he gonna butt you.
Yes,
you have a hard time killing that goat. Y'all remember me telling the story of a man that went in the barn and tried to bury that goat?
Yes.
He dug that big old hole and put the goat in the bottom of the hole and start throwing dirt on his back. Every time he throw it, he shake it off and pack it.
Yes,
and he shook so much off and packed it till he just come right about that hole.
Yes,
somebody will get that later. For God so loved the world.
Yes,
I'm glad he loved me. Are you glad he loved you?
Yes.
Tell somebody sitting next to you, my father loved me.
My father loved me.
Your father loved you?
Yes.
And then what you said on Color Purple, your pa loved you, my pa loved me.